Good evening, I'm Greg Kostraba from the KBACH Performance Studio. We've got musicians from the Downtown Chamber Series with me. I'll be chatting with their executive and music director, Mark Dix, in just a few minutes. First, let's hear the Downtown Chamber Series perform Strum by Jessie Montgomery on 89.5 Classical KBACH. Thank you. Strum by Jessie Montgomery, performed in the KBACH Performance Studio by violinist Leslie Fry Onderegg and Aaron Ricciero, violist Mark Dix, and cellist Peter Lorenzo Onderegg. They'll be performing on the next concerts in the Downtown Chamber Series tomorrow and Monday evenings at 7:30 at Shepley Bullfinch in downtown Phoenix. Welcome to all of you.
Thanks for having us.
Tell me about why you picked that piece and why it's on this program that you've got coming up.
So Jessie is a string quartet player. She was in the Catalyst Quartet for many years and also a fantastic composer. And she has now left the quartet and she is doing composing full time. So her works have really hit the string scene by storm. Her pieces are very popular now. She brings in a lot of folk elements, but a rhythmic layering that is really compelling. And I think one of the biggest aspects with her as a composer for us as musicians is oftentimes composers are writing music that they don't play the instruments for. And so to have a composer that knows our instruments so well really translates to the score. Her pieces are difficult, but everything is playable and very intricate.
I'm talking to Mark Dix. He's part of the Downtown Chamber Series in Phoenix. They have a couple of concerts coming up tomorrow and Monday evenings. Mark, you're the founder and the executive director of the group. Tell me about the genesis of the group. You started, 20-some-odd years ago now?
Yeah, we started in 2000, so we're in our 24th year. The project is really built around celebrating the amazing wealth of musicians we have in Phoenix, and as well as our visual arts scene. Which started on Roosevelt Row and First Fridays, but the gallery scene and just what we have in our city with the visual arts is a fantastic place to present chamber music. So we host our concerts in these spaces. We're like a MASH unit. We move around town, downtown, and in different spaces. And so the one we have coming up is at Shepley Bullfinch Architects, an amazing building from 1964, the punch card building. And in one of those rotunda structures on Central and Osborne. And we'll also have two exhibits there, as well as our performance.
Fantastic. Now, on the program, aside from the Jessie Montgomery, you've got some Beethoven, and you've got pieces by Jonny Greenwood of Radiohead, and that's what's coming up next on the broadcast. Tell us about these two works, Oil and Future Markets.
So Greenwood, as a high school kid, was a violist in Oxford, England, and was in the Youth Symphony and kind of following the normal classical path. His favorite composers were Messiaen and Ligeti and other contemporary composers that inspired him. And he went to school in composition, and he was also interested in bands like the Pixies and other bands that were popular at that time. And he was only at music school for 3 weeks before the band that he was in at that time, Radiohead, got signed to EMI label. And so he left music school to chart his career as Radiohead. And so this piece, There Will Be Blood, was only his second film score, written in 2007. And it's just an incredibly evocative music. The first 15 minutes of the movie has no script, just the gritty realities of being an oil prospector in the late 1800s and all that that involves. So he doesn't have a lot of themes. These are not big sweeping melodies that connect to the characters. It's more soundscapes and how he so delicately uses the range of our instruments to bring about these moods, most of which are very menacing. But there is a stream of hope that goes through it as well.
Okay, well, let's hear these two movements by Jonny Greenwood, Oil and Future Markets. Musicians from the Downtown Chamber Series here on 89.5 KBACH from the KBACH Performance Studio.
Thank you.
two movements, Oil and Future Markets, from Jonny Greenwood's score to the 2007 film There Will Be Blood. We heard musicians from the Downtown Chamber Series, violinist Leslie Fry Onderegg and Aaron Rakiro, violist Mark Dix, and cellist Peter Lorenzo Onderegg performing here in the KBACH Performance Studio. That's music on the group's performance in downtown Phoenix tomorrow and Monday evenings. You can learn more about the concert and the series on their website, downtownchamberseries.org. Mark, a lot of contemporary music on the program, but also music on the cusp of Beethoven's last period. What's the connection?
Well, some of it has to do, as I mentioned in the Greenwood, that there's a thin layer of hope amidst all of the menacing content of the movie There Will Be Blood. In Beethoven, of course, we all know of his very difficult life. And I think this quartet sort of marks a point in time when a lot of things were crushing down on him. He had a recently failed love affair, a progressive loss of his hearing, health problems, and financial insecurity. And in a letter to a friend of his in 1810, he wrote, "If I had not read somewhere that no one should quit life voluntarily while still able to do something worthwhile, I would have been dead long ago, and certainly by my own hand. Life is so beautiful, but for me, it is poisoned forever." So as dark as that quote is, it is interesting that Beethoven always seems to find space for hope. And I think it's particularly interesting in this quartet that is in a minor key and has a lot of grit to it, that the themes, most of which occur in the violin, but throughout the piece, and that really soften the edges of what was a very difficult life for him.
And then there's that ending, like the last minute of the piece, that it just kind of turned, the sunlight comes in.
Yes, at the end of the piece, he switches to a major key, and there is that sort of beam of sunlight that comes through. And I think that maybe is one of the reasons people are so drawn to Beethoven, is that he speaks to the realities of our life, but he also gives us a connection to beauty in a way that transcends time. And that's why we're still listening to him and playing his music after several centuries.
That's right. Absolutely profound music. This is the first movement of the Sirigoso Quartet, the string quartet number 11 by Ludwig van Beethoven. Musicians from the Downtown Chamber Series in the KBACH Performance Studio on 89.5 KBACH. Thank you. First movement from Ludwig van Beethoven's String Quartet No. 11, aptly named the Sirioso. We heard the musicians from the Downtown Chamber Series, violinist Leslie Fry Onderegg and Aaron Ricciero, violist Mark Dix, and cellist Peter Lorenzo Onderegg in the KBACH Performance Studio. Thank you so much for coming in. This was terrific.
Thanks so much for having us.
The next concerts on the Downtown Chamber Series will take place tomorrow and Monday evenings at 7:30 at Shepley Bullfinch Architects in downtown Phoenix. You can purchase tickets at downtownchamberseries.org and at the door. I'm Greg Kustraba. You can hear this interview and performance again at our website. It's performance.kbach.org.